the thumbnails you gotta make to survive on YouTube. It's getting ridiculous. Okay, we have a really interesting video to do. The saltwater aquarium. You guys know that we were going to do a bubble tip anemone aquarium. When I introduced the anemones into the tank, a couple of things happened. One, I noticed we had some hitchhikers. We have a couple of little cute porcelain crabs. Absolutely adorable. Not mad at that. No big deal. But then something else came in and coated the entire aquarium. So I started filming this over a month ago, and I was actually hesitant in whether or not I was going to show it. But I thought, you know, I could show the perfect tank and the clownfish are now in. The anemones have split. Everybody's doing absolutely fantastic, but there's nothing to learn there. The learning is in all of the problems and issues that arise in the aquarium. That's how you become a better aquarist, and not everybody's gonna have this issue, but I'm gonna arm you with more knowledge. So, it turns out everything that was in here and the problem that happened was fungal. By introducing this rock, an imbalance occurred, and it was the right environment for this fungus to just go nuts in here. This is how I removed it. You know the downside to this is I actually kind of like the way it looks, but I also know that it is not that great to have in the tank. Takes away from it. It's covering the entire background. But again, I don't think it looks all that bad. Tools of the trade that we're going to be using. Go to your local Walmart, hardware store, something. Go into the dish aisle or where their cleaning supplies is. Get yourself a bottle scrubber and like a scouring thing. This is really good for rocks and whatnot and cleaning, getting into crevices, and of course, scrubbing. First thing we got to do though, of course, shut the equipment off. Now, all we're really going to do is get rid of it for today. But then we gotta talk about why it's here in the first place so we can prevent it from coming back. Now, as I remove this stuff, I want it out of the tank. I don't want it floating around. I'm gonna try to remove as much as I can with a hose as I go. Most of it removed. It doesn't look good. Just all free floating at this point. Almost impossible to remove with the hose. I'm gonna do a huge water change. And with my luck, within 3 days, it was completely back. All of that fungus had come back entirely. Manually removing it and doing the water changes simply wasn't cutting it. And I was starting to get nervous, like, the problem is I kind of like the look of it, but I also wanted to have a more healthier aquarium. And although it wasn't harming anybody, I knew that over time it was eventually going to make it to the anemones and possibly choke them out. But I'm also in Canada, and that means that fish medications and a lot of chemicals are no longer available here because there's populations of fish that are starting to show resistance to the chemicals we use in the aquarium hobby. So Health Canada banned all fish medications. We're technically kind of screwed up here, guys, and there's nothing a whole lot of us can do until we wait and something pops up. And this, I've shown you before, popped up recently. A company in Canada, I believe, made Superprotect. My local fish store now sells it, and that's how I came in contact with it. He's like, he was telling me about it, and I was like, there's no way that does everything you're saying. So this is supposed to be directed towards, oh, and they can't say that it's a medication. They can't say what it actually does. It just promotes fish health. But it does say that it's 100% plant materials. I can say all this because I don't answer to Health Canada, but because I'm not this company that's trying to make this medication for the hobby. But this is definitely a medication. It treats fungal things. So I've been using it in my quarantine tank, like I told you guys, because it's very strong. You can't smell. It's very strong smelling, like garlic. We know that that can also treat internal parasites. So I pour a little bit on their food, let it soak in and dry. Then I add it to the tank. They eat it, they ingest it. I'm not only treating internal, but external with this. It's really good for fish breeding too. So when you have eggs laid and you don't want the unfertilized ones to like kind of infect the rest and kill off all the eggs, you can put this in the tank and it'll just take care of the fungus. Anyways, I added this to the tank and the next day everything was gone. There is still a little bit trace amounts here and there. It's just dead and it turned into a dark color. But it just needs to be manually removed and I can do that here shortly. So that is how I cured that. Now, if you're Canadian, you definitely need to have this. You can have it in America as well. You can get it on Amazon. I'll leave a link in the description. I'm not sure if it's in stock right now, but like add it to a fish list. Get it immediately because this is going to sell out fast. That wasn't the only problem.
We had an aptasia problem, and you can treat aptasia in a couple ways with like home remedies in the aquarium, which typically should work. I tried basting it in boiling water. That didn't kill it. Then I tried lemon juice. That didn't kill it. I'm just going to have to take the rock out and smash that little piece off, and that'll be it. I might as well do it right now. Oh, got the infected rock off. And this is all that's left for the anatomy. Poor guy.
I'm just gonna set him right there for now.
Luckily, I got a bunch of other rocks that I can replace with, but... Well, the aptasia's gone. See, I was just trying to smack this little piece off, which I did, but then it shattered all of the pieces. Now with all of the issues out of the way, we can now appreciate the tank and kind of talk about what's going on with it. Obviously, we've got a bunch of clownfish and the initial or the future plans of what I want this to happen. And I might even share with you something really big. So the tank looks absolutely phenomenal now. The clownfish have all been added. We've added in a dozen clownfish. Even though we only started off with three anemones, we now have around 15 of them. Now these guys, as they grow bigger and bigger, like this one on the side here, that's actually really big, bigger than the size of an open hand. What happens is as they get really big, they split into two and move to a new location. These guys can literally get up. They don't like scamper around the tank, but they can move. And one even went right over into this corner, as you can see. Right there. See them? Boop. We added in a dozen clownfish, all of which are doing well. They've all adapted to swimming in and around the anemones at this point, which is really cool to see because for the first couple of weeks they wouldn't. And I was like, well, what's the point of having an anemone in clownfish tank if they're not going to interact? It's just been after over the last couple of days, few days, I've noticed that they're now swimming in and amongst the bubble tips. With that said, I want to add in maybe three or four more large rocks like this and have them coated in the anemone. So it's just like an anemone forest. And I also wanted to coat the entire back room. Just have all anemones in this. I also want to get another 12 clownfish. I'm just waiting until like a new batch can come available. I don't want to have too many fish from the same batch just in case any breeding happens, which will definitely happen with this many clownfish and keeping them this happy in a 120 all by themselves. It looks bare right now, but bear with me, give it time. You want to see something really cool? We also have a 375-gallon saltwater tank that many of you guys said, that is begging to be a reef. Joey, you need to turn that into a reef tank. Obviously, I'm a fish keeper first, so I like the fish more than I like everything else. And the fish that are in here, mainly Kevin the Stars and Stripes Puffer and the clown Trigger, is going to cause me a tremendous amount of problems if I try to add in coral. So I thought to myself, what is something that I would really like to see in a coral aquarium? Why can't we take one of the cheapest, easiest to grow coral and just simply coat the entire tank in it? I think that would look really cool. It'd be very different because a lot of the times when it comes to saltwater hobbyists and saltwater aquariums, because the selection of fish and coral are so very similar, I find like all tanks start to look the same. So I decided I'm going to coat all of this in green star polyps, but it wasn't that easy. Kevin didn't want it to be that possible. He's constantly attacking them. He has knocked down a few of the coral here and there, but for the most part, these polyps are starting to come out. They're starting to grow, and they're going to grow fast and propagate incredibly quickly. Let's give this 6 months to a year, and we'll see what it looks like then. The tank has already been running for a year. All the fish in it have been with me for about a year now as well. So we'll see what happens over time, and we'll go from there. These guys all have to get, they're not even halfway grown, so they're all going to get a lot bigger. I would like to add some more fish in here, but everything's balanced out so much and so well. But it'll be interesting to see this tank and what happens over the next 6 months. So long as we can get Kevin to leave these guys alone, like the polyps everywhere, I added in 40 of them. Out of the 40, how many do we have left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 22, 3, 4, 5, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2. So I can see 30, but you know, there's some knocked down and he's even eaten a couple of them. But once he realizes they're not food, he leaves them alone. Yeah, it'll be really cool to see what this tank does in 6 months to a year. But yeah, I'm excited.
So that's it with my saltwater journey. I mean, I wanted you guys to see the ups and downs of saltwater. It wasn't that crazy, and the odds of you having to deal with anything that I've had to deal with are incredibly slim. But if you do, now you know, right? And I think that if we give this time, and we've only had a little bit of patience with this anemone. I mean, we've only had it for a couple months. Started with like 3 or 4 like little bubble tips. Now we've got like 15 of them. Give it. We gotta have some patience and let things grow in. This is way more fun for me to see happening than like seeing plants, because I know the planta tanks are going to grow in. I know it's going to happen. But with these guys, it's like, man, we're growing and propagating like animals. It's so much different and really cool. So I should probably end this with, I'm going to leave a link in the description to this stuff. I don't know if it's actually in stock right now, but when you can get it, make sure you get it. Even if you don't need it for anything right now, it's better to have this available than not. If I didn't have this, I'd have a lot more problems with these saltwater tanks. And I am actually really grateful for using it with my quarantine, because I haven't had a single fish die in my quarantine tank since I started using it. And when you buy like 20, 30, 40, 50 fish at once, you're going to lose a couple here and there, and it just hasn't happened. Coincidence? Or is it that stuff? I don't know, but I'm really excited to see what you guys do with it and get your feedback on it, and maybe this is the next big thing for Canada. But as a fellow Canadian, I feel like I do have to try to at least bring these types of things to the masses when I can. Anyways, I'll see you guys in the next video.